Hey everyone, this is Heidi from the blog Hands Occupied with another knitting video tutorial. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to knit super fast lace, which is very beginner friendly if you're a first time lace knitter. When some folks hear the phrase lace knitting, they get a little nervous, especially if they are newer knitters. But this super fast lace that I'm going to show you how to work today is really just a matter of knowing where to place your increases, which are yarn overs, which are super easy, and decreases to form this really cute diamond shape. So what we've got here is I've cast on 23 stitches on my needle. And we start with a wrong side row by knitting one, purling 21, and knitting one. So that's just a little background for where we're starting this lace off on. So for the first row, we're going to work on the right side. What we're going to do is purl one, knit two together. So working two knit stitches together as one. And next we are going to knit three, yarn over, knit one, yarn over, knit three more. And then we will slip one, knit two stitches together, and pass the slip stitch over for a decrease of two stitches. Then we will knit three, yarn over, knit one, yarn over, knit three, and then we will slip one, knit one, pass the slip stitch over, and end our row on a purl one. So what we've set up here in this first row, we can look at in the swatch here. So what we've done with the yarn over, knit one, yarn overs is form the point of this diamond that we see here in the swatch. With the slip one, knit two together, pass slip stitch over, we've decreased at the center of this half diamond here, and then we've done formed the point of another diamond and then finished out another partial for the edging. Just to give you a little bit of context. Next, we are going to go to the wrong side of our work, and what we're going to do on that wrong side is what we do on every wrong side row in this stitch, which is knit one, purl 21, and then knit one. So let me just quickly fast forward through knit one, purl 21, and knit one. 20 and 21, and then knit one. Next, we are on to our right side again, and we're going to work row three. So surprise, surprise, this row once again starts and ends with a purl one. So we're going to purl one and then start with knit two together, knit two, yarn over, knit three, yarn over, then we will knit two, slip one, knit two together, pass the slip stitch over, like so. And you should make sure that those pass slip stitch overs are lined up straight and that your yarn overs are at an angle from each other, forming that center that we talked about before and the next piece of the diamond that we also talked about before. So then we will knit two, yarn over, knit three, yarn over, knit two, slip one, knit one, pass the slip stitch over, and finish up with that purl one before turning to the wrong side of our work and doing what we always do on the wrong side of our work in this stitch, which is knit one, purl 21, and knit one. One thing you can do when working these wrong side rows, and I've shared this tip before in other videos on this site, It's a great way when you're doing lace, when your wrong side rows are always all purled across, or something like this, which is knit one, purl 21, knit one. It's a great way to keep count to make sure that you have the right number of stitches on your row. This quick lace, like a lot of other laces, every single row has the same exact stitch count. So it's an easy way to keep track of whether or not you've done the correct mix of increases and decreases, which is why this lace is pretty beginner friendly for lace knitters. And now we finished that row. Next, we're on to row 5 on the right side, starting with our usual purl one and knit two together. Then we will knit one before we yarn over, knit 5, yarn over, and then we will knit one, slip one, knit two together, pass the slip stitch over, and knit one more, yarn over, knit 5, yarn over, knit one, then our slip one, knit one, pass the slip stitch over, and purl one before we turn to the wrong side of our work for our usual wrong side row song and dance. Now we're ready to work on row 7. So what we're gonna do is start our row like usual with our purl one, knit two together, and then we are going to yarn over, knit 7, and then yarn over one more time. 5, 6, and 7. Then we'll yarn over. And then, since there are just 3 stitches left to form the point of this triangle, or half diamond, however one you want to look at it, we will slip one, knit 2 together, and then pass the slip stitch over, and then yarn over, knit 7, yarn over one more time, slip one, knit one, pass the slip stitch over, and purl one before working our knit one, purl 21, knit one wrong side row like usual, which I will do now. Now turning to the right side of our work, we are officially halfway through this quick lace. And so what we're going to do at this point is start increasing here and here to form this half triangle, or half diamond, aka triangle. And then as we increase those, we decrease here and here to form the tapered end of these 2 diamonds on the sides. So to do that, we're going to purl one, knit one, yarn over, knit 3, and then we'll form that center spine by doing slip one, knit 2 together, pass the slip stitch over, knit 3 on the other side of it. Then we will yarn over, knit 1, yarn over, and then once again, we'll knit 3, slip 1, knit 2 together, pass the slip stitch over, knit 3, and then we will finish with a yarn over, knit 1, and purl 1 to complete row 9 before working our wrong side row as usual. Okay, now we are on row 11, which starts with purl 1, knit 2, yarn over, knit 2 more, and then we slip 1, knit 2 together, pass the slip stitch over, and just like before, you'll know you're doing that in the right spot when that spine of slip stitch overs line up in a straight line, as you can see here in the swatch. Then knit 2, yarn over, knit 3, yarn over, knit two, slip one, knit two together, pass the slip stitch over. Same rules for lining up those past slip stitch overs vertically apply here. Knit two, yarn over, and finish up row 11 with knit two and purl one before working the other side as usual. All right, now row 13 is our second to last right side row. So we've almost made it through one repeat of this lace. And now we're going to purl one, knit three, yarn over, knit one, slip one, knit two together, pass the slip stitch over, knit one, yarn over, then knit one, two, three, four, and five, yarn over, knit one, slip one, knit two together, pass the slip stitch over, knit one, yarn over, knit three, and finish with that purl one. Now one more wrong side row, one more right side row, and we'll have this lace put to bed. And now we're ready for this last row of lace. So we're starting with purl one, knit four this time, yarn over, and now we've reached the apex point of this diamond. So instead of doing any knits, we just slip one, knit two together, and pass the slip stitch over, completing that final point of this diamond. Then we yarn over, knit seven, yarn over, form the point of the other diamond with our slip one, knit two together, pass slip stitch over, yarn over, knit four, and end out this row with an easy purl one. So, woohoo, you did it! And taking a look at this set of lace on my needle next to the lace down here, you'll notice a couple things. The lace down here lays a lot more flat. It doesn't bow up like this swatch does, and it doesn't bow out quite as much. So the difference between these two panels of lace is that this has been wet blocked. So I've soaked it in lukewarm water for about 20 minutes, patted it dry, and pinned it so that I could still maintain a little bit of bowing in the cast on edge and the sides, but I got it so it would lay really flat. And so that's always a good technique to get your finished product to look how you want with lace knitting, especially if this is your first project. That's a good tip to keep in mind. And then if I hold this flat and line these up, you can see exactly how two repeats of this lace might look. You can see that where we've widened to the seven stitches across the middle of this diamond, if we kept going through the repeat, that center set of diamonds would be formed. And the repeat on this lace becomes really, really beautiful and clear when you see it repeated a couple of times. This super fast lace comes together super fast, especially when you work with a bulky yarn like the one I demonstrated with in this video. If you have any other tips for knitting super fast lace, let us know in the comments, and that's a great place to ask questions if you've got them. Don't forget to tune in again soon for more knitting video tutorials.